Hi there, my name is Kevin, and welcome to this video where we're continuing our exploration of intersection observers. If you missed the beginning of the series, I encourage you to go and check it out. But what we're doing in this one is, when you're scrolling down a page and those things like slowly fade in as you go, well, that we're going to be doing that in this video and seeing how we can do it, because intersection observers are pretty much perfect for that. So let's go and check it out. Before we jump into the content of this video, I just want to say a big thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. If you don't know about Skillshare, it is a massive online learning community with over 25,000 classes. By getting a membership with them, you get access to the entire library, unlimited access to everything, which is really, really cool. They have classes in web development, in UI, in UX, in Photoshop, in all sorts of really, really cool things. So it's a really, if you're interested in learning and you just want to absorb tons and tons of information, I'm guessing you do if you're here. It's an awesome, really cool platform. As an added bonus too, if you use the link down below, the first 500 people who use it will get access to Skillshare for 2 months for free. And one of the classes I think you might like since you're watching this video is the JavaScript Toolkit. Its focus is cleaner, faster, and better code. It's a really nice overview. It's not the longest course, which is also nice because you get to plow through it pretty quickly. So as I mentioned, if you use the link down below, you get 2 months for free. If you do sign up for an annual membership after that, it's less than $10 a month, and that gives you access to their entire library unlimited, which is really, really cool and awesome. It's a platform I've used. I keep watching stuff on there like that JavaScript class and others. So I really do think that you will like it, and I really encourage you to check it out. And when you do, you'll be joining up with more than 7 million other people who are also in there and getting their learn on with Skillshare. Thank you very much to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Now let's get on with what we came here for. Before we get into this, I just want to say that I'm continuing working on a file that I started last week where I did the navigation. So when I get into the JavaScript, if you didn't see that video, you're going to see some JavaScript that's already in there, but I'm not actually touching it. But just if you're like, why is there all this code there already? That is from the last video where we changed the navigation on scroll. You can check that video out if you do want to. And if you didn't see my original video on the introduction to intersection observer, that one I really go into detail on how these are working. Whereas in this video, I'm just sort of making it work. So if you want more information and understanding on how this intersection observer is working and all the different things I'm doing to set it up, I would really recommend going and checking out that first video. So if you did follow along with the last video, it's the same deal in this one. There's a link down below to the starting files as well as the finished files. They're both GitHub repos, so you can either follow along with what I'm doing here and the finished ones. If you ever get stuck or anything like that, you can go in there and take a look. So let's just take a quick look at the markup to see how I've set this up a little bit. So you can see I have three columns here. So that's these three columns right there. I have a fade in on class on those. So we'll start with those ones, and then we'll look at how we can also bring in the these things, because we're actually going to do it in a clever way to make it all work with a single class. So we can actually use the same observer for all of them, which is kind of cool. So we're going to come over to my file here, and these are on my columns. So right here, I'm just going to add in a fade in, and we're going to start with these having an opacity of 0 on them, and we'll add a transition to the opacity of, we'll say 250 milliseconds transition. You got to add the I there, transition, and we'll have it ease in. And then what we're going to use is a class called appear. So if we have a fade in with also a class of appear on it, it's going to get an opacity of 1. So if I save that, whoop, you can see that they just disappeared. So perfect, we know that everything is working. So if I come over to my observers here, and we're going to create our new observer. So I'm just going to, let's come up to the top here. I'm going to turn word wrap off just for a second to make it a bit cleaner. So here we can do our const, let's call these faders for lack of a better word. So to be a document query selector. In this case, we want to do a query selector all, because we're going to have multiple. It's not just one item. And that's anything that has the class of fade in. So anything with the class of fade in. Oh, let's turn word wrap back on because we're there. So there we go. Anything with the class of fade in, we'll be calling it a fader. So let's save that. So let's come down and write our observer for that. So for this observer, I'm going to call it appear on scroll, because I think that name makes a lot of sense. And appear on scroll will be a new intersection observer. And once again, we do need to have a function. And we also want to have our options on there as well. So in our function, we're going to want to be looking for our entries as well as appear on scroll. And now we can come in and write our actual function in here. So that's working, but you're seeing we're getting an error here for options not being defined. So let's come and set those options up right away. Const, and I should call them, we'll call them appear options. So const appear options will be equal to, and we'll do nothing for now, but once again, we'll come back and add some stuff into that a little bit later on. So inside of our appear on scroll here, inside of our function now, what do we want to do in our function? What we want to do, like we did last time, and which you'll be doing all the time with these, is our entries for each, and set it up for each individual entry, and then another function. So then we can pull up our arrow function. And in this case, what we want to do is, it's really important to do this, where we're going to say if it's false that the entry is intersecting. So if you remember from the very first video I looked at when we explored these, intersection observer, whether or not it's intersecting, is going to fire as soon as the page loads. And it's going to say this is or isn't intersecting. If it's not intersect, so if it does that and we have a function here that's toggling a class on and off, that's going to be a problem, or just toggling a class on in this case. But that's going to be a problem because it's going to turn the class on everywhere and we're not going to see what it's actually doing. So the first thing we have to do is say, if it isn't intersecting with the page, we want to return. Let's get the heck out of here. So return. This function's done. Don't look at anything else. But if it is intersecting with the page, now we can actually do something. So in this case, we can say our entry target class list add, and we want to add in appear, because that was the class that we just created. And the other thing we're going to do at the same time is appear on scroll. So we're going back to our actual function here that we created, our event, our intersection observer that we created here, and we're going to on observe entry target. So if you're not sure why I'm doing that, you can check out the first video that I did as well. But pretty much it's just to say, stop looking at something once you've done your job. So everything is in place, but now we actually want to get it to work. So to do that, we need to come down, and we can't do it like we did when we did our navigation here. Because when we were doing that, we were observing only one thing. We were observing this section one part of our page here and paying attention to where that was. But in this case, we're going to be looking at all three of these columns. Plus, eventually, we're going to use the same thing to look at these as well. So if we're doing that, what we need to do is first do our faders, which we already set up our const for. So faders, and on the faders, we're going to do a for each. So for each fader inside of faders, we want to run appear on scroll, or we don't want to run it. We want to set up it to observe that individual fader. So now if I hit save, look at that, they all came in. So let's scroll back up to the top of the page, hit refresh. Now actually, we will run into a problem here, because when I scroll down, see how they faded in right away? Let's do that one more time. I'll scroll up, pay attention to the bottom of the page. As soon as they get there, they're already there. Like they're fading in super, super fast. So let's use our appear options here. So I'm gonna use two different options here. One of them that we're gonna do is my threshold. I want to make sure the entire image or the entire column is in the page. Whatever I'm fading in, I want the whole thing to be there before it starts to fade in. So let's leave that there, not a semicolon. Let's just hit save like that. Scroll up and refresh. So now when I get to here, you can see they haven't faded in yet. They haven't faded in. And now there we go. Then they fade in. So only once the entire thing is visible will they fade in. So that's good. But I think we also could use a root margin on this as well. Root margin. In this case, we're looking at the bottom. So it'd be 0 pixels, 0 pixels, the bottom, let's say like 200 pixels, negative 200 and 0 pixels. So let's scroll back up and I'll save my JavaScript file here. And now when we scroll down, not only do we need the whole thing to be in the screen, but it needs to be pretty far into the screen. I think I overdid it there, but now they're fading in. So I think I'd probably make this a bit smaller, maybe negative 100, something like that. So they're fading in once we're 100 pixels in, and I think that'll work a little bit better. Let's just try that one more time. The whole thing is there, they have 100 pixels from the bottom, and then they're fading in. Perfect, so that is working really, really nicely. Now, let's set that up to also work to get these things here to slide in. So the first thing I'm gonna have to do is come back to my CSS and come down here. So I already have my friend left and friend right. So this is anything on the left, I have a class of from left on. Any of the ones on the right, I have a from right on. I was a little bit lazy. I set up the grid columns. I set them up on a grid and used the grid columns on those specifically, which I'm not sure if I'd want to do it that way, but whatever. It's for a quick demo. I think it works. So on anything that's on the left side, we want to also do a transform of translate x. Now let's move it 50% of the way that way. And I'm going to take the same thing, but if it's on the right side, and do a positive 50%. So let's save that. And you can see they've moved out now. It's causing some side scrolling. We'll fix that in a bit. But it's moved them out to the sides like that. And then for either one of these, so for my from scroll down a little, from left, let's say my from left and actually my from right, we're going to set up for both of these, we want it to have a transition of, for now I'm just going to set up the transform so we can see it working, and then we'll add in the opacity afterwards. So we can set up our transition like that, and when both of them, let's just copy that, when both of them get the class of appear on it, they are going to get a transform of translate x of 0. So they're going to move back into their normal place. So with all that set up, now what we need to do is actually observe and make it work. Now just really fast, what I did is, if we come and look at them, I've done two things on it. I've given them from right and from left, which is positioning them, but I've given them all the class of slide in, just because that way we can set up one observer for all of them in one shot. So let's turn word wrap off for a second. So I have my faders here. I'm going to add in another one. We'll call it sliders. So document.query selector all. And in this case, we're going to be looking for anything with a class of slide in on it. So anything with the class of slide in, we've saved right to there. So now we can actually use this and say sliders for each slider appear on scroll observe slider. And it should have the same effect. And it's not working. And there's a really good reason it's not working, actually. And it's because the observer is looking for anything that's intersecting with the page. But I said up here that the whole thing has to be in the view. And that's actually causing a problem because right now they're not all the way in the view. The whole thing is actually sticking out the sides. So either we could play with our left and right margins on this and make them positive to be a lot bigger, which is an option. Or I could put the threshold down to 0. So if I put the threshold down to 0, you can see now it's actually starting to work. And as I go down, those items are starting to slide into view. There is also the problem of the side scrolling, which probably in this case, if you really wanted to set it up this way, I think the easiest way to fix it would just be to come onto the body here and say the overflow X, is it X? Yeah, is hidden. So if we do that, and let's just go all the way back up, it should actually fix that. So these will come in like that, and then you can see they're sliding in from the left and the right like that, and we don't have any side scrolling, which is handy. So I think what I do is leave it that way, but what we're going to want to do, two more things. One, I'm going to make this so it's actually back up maybe to 250 pixels, just because the threshold is so low. So actually, let's come back up to here and refresh. And so there we go. So I think that'll work a little bit better. The other advantage with this is if your threshold is 1 and you have something really long that you're fading in for some reason, I probably wouldn't do it. But if that does happen, it will never come in. If it's longer than the viewport, it just can't hit a threshold of 1. So this might be a safer option as well. And these types are the mistakes that I think everybody can run into. So it's working, but obviously it looks weird that they're sticking out the side and coming in. So I think the other thing that's important that we do is on our from left and from right, they're also going to start with an opacity of 0, and the opacity will become 1, opacity of 1, but that means we also need to transition that. So here, let's say the opacity is, let's make it a little faster, 250 milliseconds ease in, and so we can have the 2 on there, and actually just to make it, so we're doing a transition on both the opacity and on our transform property there. So if we go and look at it now, let's refresh my page. When we scroll down, that is coming into view. Then when we get to here, it sort of fades in and slides into view at the same time. So it just grabs the attention a little bit. That was fun. That was cool. Just one, don't overdo it, please. If you do this, especially we learn new effects and they're like, whoa, that's cool. And then everything on the page is just flying in. No, please. Like using it for like a little bit, something to grab attention, a little bit extra here or there, that's fine. That's cool. But if you start really doing it, be really careful. And also just be note that people don't always like lots of animation. People might have preferred reduced animation, things like that. So just do please try and take them into account that you don't have all these things flying around, because even a normal person won't like that and they'll get the hell out. So, you know, it's a cool thing, but don't overdo it. But yeah, I think it was not only is it a cool thing, it is a good way to learn how intersection observers work. So I hope you liked that. If you did like the video, please let me know in the comments below. A big thank you to my patrons for helping support me and everything I do here on my channel. Thank you guys so much. And of course, an extra big thank you to my supporters of awesome, Lauren, Fernando, and Jonathan for being super, super generous with their support over on Patreon. If you enjoyed this video, I'm going to encourage you to hit the subscribe button. But if you're already subscribed, or even if you're not subscribed, also, if you go in the description, I do have a newsletter. So that's another way you can know that you're not missing anything, including articles I write. I do occasionally write some articles over on my website, and very, very rarely, but occasionally on other websites as well. So if you want to know everything I'm up to and you never want to miss anything, you can subscribe to my newsletter below and get that. Or actually, it should be showing up on the side card any second now as well. Click that. It should let you sign up and you'll know that you're getting everything I do. So if you like my stuff, it's a good way to keep up with everything I'm doing. Thank you very much for watching, and we're going to be continuing our intersection observer exploration. That took a lot of concentration to say, to think about that one. So we're going to be continuing that exploration in next week's video, where we're going to be looking at lazy loading images, which is probably the best thing to be using it for, honestly. It has a massive benefit to the user, just because if you're on your phone, you don't want to be getting dinged with all the data that you don't need to be using. But it also boosts the performance of your site, which Google likes, and just is a good idea to do in general too. So this is probably like, so if you really wanted to use one, you weren't, you know, you don't want these fancy effects going on, like this is a really good reason. We're going to be looking at that in next week's video. So I'm really looking forward to that. But until then, don't forget to make your corner of the internet just a little bit more awesome.